Join me in this video as I explain how the EPA range test is conducted and as I perform my own real-world EPA range test in a Kia EV6. You'll be shocked by the amazing range result I get, and I'll explain what factors contributed to that huge number. Range is perhaps the most important number that buyers consider when they're looking to buy a new EV. We all suffer from range anxiety and have terrifying visions of being stuck on the side of the road having run out of charge. A slew of range numbers are thrown at us from manufacturers and governmental agencies without giving us a real understanding of what they represent. In the US, we look to the EPA range number to tell us how far the EV can go. However, most of us have no idea how that number is calculated and what it really represents. I was one of those, and so I decided to dig deeper to get some answers. I went right to the EPA website to find out. I'll also include a link to the website in the description so you can check it out. So here's how the test is conducted, and I'll illustrate along with an example too. To begin with, the test is conducted in a lab on a dyno. The fully charged car is driven continuously over the EPA city cycle until the battery is depleted and the car can drive no further. The distance driven is recorded. The city cycle consists of a series of accelerations, decelerations, and stops designed to simulate stop-and-go city traffic. The cycle has an average speed of 21.2 miles an hour with a surprising maximum speed of 56.7 miles an hour. The distance covered is 11.04 miles. It lasts for about 31 minutes, and so the car is driven on this cycle repeatedly until the battery is fully depleted. The total distance driven is recorded. Then the car is fully charged again, and this time driven repeatedly on the highway cycle until the battery is depleted. The highway cycle has a maximum speed of 60 miles an hour with an average of 48.3 miles an hour. The distance covered is 10.26 miles and there are no stops. This cycle lasts for about 13 minutes, and so the car is driven repeatedly on this cycle until the battery is fully depleted. The distance traveled is recorded. For the purposes of an example, let's say that the car covered 428.5 miles on the city cycle and 345 miles on the highway cycle. Then an adjustment factor is applied to these numbers to account for a number of real-world factors that are not represented in the lab conditions. These factors include things such as the impact of air conditioning, of cold temperatures, and of high-speed and aggressive driving behaviors. The most common adjustment factor used is 0.7. So in our example, we would multiply the dyno numbers by 0.7 to get the adjusted numbers. Then, the adjusted city and highway range values are weighted together by 55% and 45% respectively to determine the combined city and highway driving range that appears on the EPA fuel economy label. In the case of our example, that range number would be 274 miles. Now, if you know your Kia EV6 as well, you'll have noticed that 274 is the EPA range number for the extended range all-wheel drive, the same exact car that I drive. And what I just illustrated is likely the test method that Kia used to arrive at this range number. I say likely because the EPA does allow some alternate approaches like a 5-cycle test that Tesla, Lucid, and Rivian reportedly use. But most manufacturers use the method I described. What we do know for sure is that the adjusted range number for the city cycle is 300 miles, just as in my example. You can verify that by going to the fueleconomy.gov website, finding the car, clicking on the personalized link, and changing the value of the stop-and-go traffic to 100%. You'll see that the range shows as 300 miles. Similarly, if you change the value of the stop and go to 0%, it will show you a range of 242 miles, representing the range of the car on just the highway cycle, just as in my example. Now that I've explained how the EPA range test is conducted, I'm going to conduct my own real-world EPA range test with a few modifications. The first modification is that I'm going to drive it in the real world and not do it in a lab, so I want to use the 0.7 adjustment factor. The second modification is that I won't drive until the battery is depleted, but instead I will use a smaller sample. In my test, I will deplete the battery by 25% of its capacity, or close to it. So for example, if I start with a 100% state of charge, I'll drive till I hit 75% state of charge. Then I'll take the range result of that 25% depletion and multiply that to get the estimated range for 100% of the battery. Why am I depleting by only 25% of its capacity? Well, my preliminary calculations for the city cycle showed that if I depleted 100% of the battery, I would have to drive over 300 miles in stop-and-go city traffic, which is insane. What are the downsides of doing it this way? Well, obviously, depleting down the full battery would give me a more precise number than depleting only 25% of it. 25% is a much smaller sample size. Another issue, even when you get down to zero state of charge, there are still a few miles the car can go before it completely dies. Those extra miles are not accounted for in my test. So like any other real-world test, this test is not perfect and has a margin of error. The car I'm driving is a Kia EV6 GT line all-wheel drive extended range with 20-inch wheels. I performed the test in normal mode with regen auto level 3. I'll first show you my highway test. I started with a full charge and set out on the highway in a back and forth loop. I set the cruise control to 60 miles an hour to match the top speed of the EPA highway cycle. I started with a climb and the efficiency was showing about 2.9 miles per kilowatt hour. As the terrain became flatter, the efficiency quickly increased. The traffic was also light since it was an early Sunday morning. By the time I had reached my destination, I had depleted the battery by 24% and had covered 73.2 miles in an hour and 32 minutes. That works out to an average speed of 47.7 miles an hour, remarkably close to the EPA highway cycle's 48.3 miles an hour. I multiplied this number representing 24% of the battery to estimate the full range for the 100% of the battery. Now keep in mind that that range of 305 miles is already more than the EPA published range of 274. And we haven't even added in the city cycle, which we know is going to be more efficient than the highway cycle. So you can begin to get a sense of just where this is heading. On another day, I did a similar test, but this time on city streets. I started with 100% charge and drove up and down El Camino Real, a major road with many stoplights. The speed limits range from 35 to 40 miles an hour. Since I started early on a Sunday morning, there was light traffic and not too many opportunities for braking. At a turnaround point, my efficiency was showing as 4.3 miles per kilowatt hour. As the morning wore on, the traffic became heavier, and with all that braking, my efficiency increased to 4.6 miles per kilowatt hour. I resumed my driving in the afternoon, and by the time I had depleted 24% of the battery, I had covered 91 miles. That 91 miles took a little over 4 hours, leading to an average speed of 22 miles. Once again, very close to the EPA city cycle average of 21.2 miles an hour. I multiplied this number to get the estimate for the full battery as 379 miles, just 21 miles shy of 400 miles. Now that just begins to give you a sense of how efficient this car is on city streets. When you weight these numbers for 55% city and 45% highway, the result is an amazing real-world EPA range of 345 miles. That's a whopping 26% better than the published EPA range. So what's contributing to this insane increase? Well, before I get into that, I want to share one more observation. If you compare the real-world ranges to the lab-adjusted ranges for each cycle, you will see that each real-world cycle was better than the lab cycle by 26%. That means that whatever factors increased the range increased it for both cycles equally. There wasn't one cycle that benefited more than the other cycle. So what factors contributed to this high number? Well, I'm going to have to go out on a limb and engage in a little bit of speculation here. First, let's go back to that 0.7 adjustment factor used in the lab test. Among other things, that accounts for air conditioning and cold weather. Well, I was driving in temperatures ranging from 59 degrees to 77 degrees. That's a good spread, but certainly not cold weather. It's really quite temperate, and so the climate control didn't have to work too hard to maintain the cabin temperature. The adjustment factor also accounts for high speed and aggressive driving behavior. Sorry folks, but that's just not how I drive. Aside from the 0.7 adjustment factor, I believe another important consideration is regen braking. I'm not an engineer and I don't have deep insight into regenerative braking. But I'm going to assume that even on a dyno, an EV benefits from regenerative braking when decelerating. But what's unknown is what regen level the car was set at in the lab. If you've seen my previous tests, you'll know that the EV6 has many different regen settings and that regen braking has a big impact on city efficiency. Additionally, I believe a lot of credit for the big range also has to go to Kia's smart regen system in auto mode. As I've covered in previous videos, this is a system that automatically adjusts regen based on terrain and distance and speed of the vehicle ahead. I believe that system contributed heavily to increasing the efficiency. And while this car is an all-wheel drive, it has a clutch that disengages the front motor when not needed. I assume the front motor was active all the time when on the dyno, so the clutch probably explains some of the better real-world results too. So is this 345-mile range a complete outlier and just a theoretical number? No, not quite. If you've been watching EV6 YouTube videos, you've probably come across Asian Petrolhead's test where he drove the EV6 down to 0% battery. In that test, which included a mix of highway and city driving, he achieved a range of 330 miles. And if you check out the EV6 Facebook groups, you'll see members posting range estimates even higher than what I got. But that's probably because they do a lot of city driving. Okay, so now you're probably thinking, it's all well and good to get big range numbers when you've got high proportion of city driving and you're doing only 60 on the highway. But what about when I'm on the highway on a road trip and want to go fast? What's my range then? Well, check out my video where I do an efficiency and range test by driving the EV6 at 55, 65, and 75 miles an hour. The link is in the top right corner of your screen. I hope watching this video has given you a better understanding of what the EPA range number means and how it translates into a real-world test with some pretty amazing results. I hope this will help you better estimate how far you can go in your car. Please consider making a donation using Super Thanks. It will support the many hours that I put into doing these tests and making these videos. Thank you for watching. Please give the video a like, share your comments below, and subscribe to the Driver Download.